Kreepers, what's up, you crazy creeps? It is a scorcher out already, and I am standing in this little alleyway here, and behind me is this incredibly cool, kind of like futuristic alien-esque style painting there with like the green alien or maybe even a creeper hand poking out of the little spaceship there. And I also got the guys on my shirt here, the aliens from The Simpsons, but myself, including a lot of folks, have always been intrigued with aliens, from E.T. to Mac and Me, all the way to a character that I've known and loved pretty much my whole life. He came around in 1986 and had a show for about 4 years until 1990. And the character I'm telling you guys about is ALF. That's right, Alien Life Form. Now, there has been a ton of famous aliens and creatures throughout Hollywood movie, television show history, but I have to say the Melmacian ALF has got to be one of my all-time favorites. And there is actually a connection to the city of Gresham, Oregon, to ALF. That's right, the Alien Life Form that ate cats actually has a connection here to Portland, well, Gresham and Portland as well. We're going to take a little creep over to a place that is tied into one of the actresses from the show. Stay tuned, today's gonna be a fun one. Looks like there's another little alien creature right here. He's even got one on his hat. And where we're going is just right down here, not too far from that mural, actually. And I'm excited for this one, you guys. Like I said, I loved ALF. I even remember watching him with my grandma. First episode was in 86. They even had some Saturday morning cartoons of ALF, or maybe it was just a cartoon. I'm not sure if it was actually on the classic Saturday morning lineup. But I also remember for a while Burger King had a little collaboration with ALF, and they released a ALF puppet, and there was like a couple different varieties of the puppet, and also a little record that would come with the ALF puppet, so you could kind of dance and sing along to the songs. I believe it was the Melmacian something or another. If you guys remember those, make sure you chime in. But you know, tons of merch. And we're gonna talk a lot more about ALF when we get up here, and also the connection to Gresham. Just walked past this little bookstore here, books around the corner, and I noticed this little alien book. They almost look like little minions. And the big bad, three little aliens and the big bad robot. All right, so if you guys can see behind me here, class of 2021 and the big G there, that might give you a little hint as to why we're here. This is actually the brand new parking lot to Gresham High School. That's right, Gresham High School on Main Street here in Gresham, Oregon. This is actually my high school as well. I graduated here in 1999. As you can see there, the class of 2021 is just wrapping up things for their school year. A lot of people moving on. A lot has changed since 1967. A lot has changed since 1999. When I went here, it was still the original facade. But I wanted to bring you guys here today because this high school actually has a tie-in to ALF. That's right. This is the backside here, which is all brand new. But not only did I go here, a famous actress, you may know her as Kate Tanner from the show, but that's right, this is the notable location for Luann Ruth Schneiden. That's right, born January 8th of 1949 here in Portland, Oregon. Best known for her role on ALF as the mom. And I just find that so cool because, like I said, I just absolutely love ALF. She also had some recurring roles on Three's Company for about three seasons, she was a repairing actress on that show as well, which I also loved. She was short cast in a short-lived series called Paper Dolls, opposite of Lloyd Bridges and Luann Hutton. She appeared as Emily Phillips in the second season of Cheers. So the drama department here did great. Like I said, she was born in Portland, Oregon, January 8th of 1949. She was kind of an introvert. She describes herself as being kind of shy. And so at an early age, her and her mom thought it would probably be the best decision to get into acting or some sort of drama. So at like 8 or 9, she decided she was going to become an actress and decided to keep pushing herself to memorizing scripts and everything like that. And by the time she was 14, she was actually really serious about it. And that's when she was enrolled here in the drama department at Gresham High School here. So pretty cool to think that, you know, somebody that I grew up watching really as a kid, even to these days, I watch ALF. For 4 seasons, she was the mom. And I pulled up some other things about kind of her personal life and other things that maybe a lot of fans might not know about ALF. ALF was so famous at the time that the puppet actually had its own makeup artist, hairstylist. I mean, the puppet was their main, you know, bread and butter, so to speak. So she felt like, you know, she was stoked on the show. She loved doing it. And she basically accredits it as one of her favorite things that she did. But the cast and everybody was kind of off put by the fact that they kind of came second, you know, to this puppet. And in fact, I hate to even say the word puppet because the guy that created ALF insisted that the actors and actresses actually didn't call him a puppet. They wanted them to refer him as either ALF or a alien. You know, he took the puppeteering of it very serious. And so a lot of the cast and characters that played on the shows were kind of like weary about how, I wouldn't say how serious he was about the puppeteering, because he, you know, put a lot of effort and time into learning puppeteering, and then, you know, to have one of his puppets really take off, I can see where he, you know, wanted people to take him serious. But they were kind of like, you know, here's ALF having its makeup done. So they insisted that none of the actors or actresses actually, nobody on set, unless you're actually, you know, in charge of working on the puppet or working on ALF. Sorry, if I say that again, he might eat me like a cat. Sorry, ALF. They couldn't touch him. They couldn't hug him. They couldn't put their hands on his shoulders. He insisted that none of the people on set touched him. And they kind of had to work around the puppet. The puppet was, you know, the main actor. So they had like a raised stage, and all the people in charge of the puppet were kind of down below in like a little hole on the stage. And so they would have to do each scene depending upon where the puppet would be placed. And sometimes they even had, if I remember, like in the opening scene, they actually had an actor, and I can't think of his name right now, he's a small person, actually play ALF in the costume. So there was times where she said they would have to cut scene and make sure the guy down below, because they're, you know, they're 3 or 4, I wouldn't say 3 or 4 feet, but they're a little bit farther down on the stage than most of the regular actors up top. So it made it hard for them, you know, to film. But right here is where she basically got her start. And yeah, I just think that's so cool. You know, it's like, if you go to her television and film, you know, roles and stuff, there's just so many to even to name, that I basically just named a few. You know, all throughout her career, it seemed like she just landed all kinds of gigs. And I think she was even on Murder, She Wrote. She was on an episode of Magnum PI. And I think what she says, what credits her for that, is the fact that she decided to take a lot of plot roles. She would sign herself up for TV, you know, series and episodes that really haven't even been established yet. They were just running plots for them at the time. And she wanted to just kind of like see how things were going to be. And I think that made her a really well-rounded actress. That big G in there is pretty cool for Gresham. But I think that made her a really well-rounded actor altogether, because she wasn't, you know, set in one role. She was able to do all kinds of different characters and recurring roles on different seasons, and people got used to that. You know, if you watched your favorite show and then all of a sudden the next door neighbor or the person they were having in the episode was different, I could always tell. You know, it's like when they changed Chrissy out on Three's Company and things like that. So I have to give her credit for kind of just making it happen. You know, when you're serious about something, you just kind of really start to make things happen. But this is the backside of the new school. I wanted to show you guys this real quick. We're going to actually creep around the front too, and I'm going to show you where the actual drama department would have sat when she went to school here. So here is the just kind of the side of the school here. And I believe, which was still kind of this vicinity, was the new, well, is the new band area. You can kind of see here with this, what is that, like a big clarinet, I believe. It's pretty cool. And this side of the school, even when I went to school here, was the drama department and the band. So that's pretty darn cool that they kind of kept most of it in the same vicinity. But this is all brand new. This is nice. And basically through these doors right here on this side of the building, it would have been the drama department. We would have went right through those doors into the auditorium there. And there's a huge stage and almost like probably a brand new theater. It was pretty darn big when I went to school here too, so I remember going to a lot of the shows too, and a lot of the performances that they put on were always really good. I think the drama department here has always been really good. Obviously in 67 it was a lot different looking, but still pretty cool to think that she came right out of those doors at some point. So yeah, the front here, and I have to say this shade right here feels great. This is all been reconstructed just in the last, oh, I say they just finished maybe last year. Oh yeah, here's the this is still the auditorium. You guys can see right there, it actually is still the auditorium. Very cool. And it looks like they might even have like a little concession stand booth there. Oh yeah, it says right on the door there, right there, concessions. So it's cool that they left the kind of the area in the same location. Now after she graduated from here, she went on to Portland State and a theater company as well before moving to New York, and then eventually moving to LA. And like I said, I really credit her for, you know, really just taking those roles throughout her time. Really improved her work, and it, you know, it didn't limit her acting ability to just keep taking those plot roles. Or I'm sorry, not plot roles, pilot roles. I wanted to show you guys this part of the building here. This has all been reconstructed, but they actually kept the gymnasium right here with the little, I don't know if you call that Art Deco style, kind of Art Deco style front there, the original. So this facade right here is actually more than likely what it looked like back even in 67. I know for a fact it looked like that here in 99. But they were able to keep these front doors looking the same. All these years later, they were able to kind of salvage some of the history. So that's pretty darn cool. And it's still the gym, the gymnasium. And I have to say, it is cooking. I might have to wrap this up a little sooner than I wanted to, just because it is getting so darn hot. I like these old street lamp kind of looking deals that they put in back here, but this is all brand new, which looks pretty darn nice. It's almost like a college now. It was fairly nice when I went to school here too, but definitely not this nice. And I believe these pieces here were also some of the original columns. Yep, I believe those are some of the pieces of the original building they were able to salvage. Here's another column here. So it looks like 1940. So yeah, the school would have looked like that old facade that we just saw. And it's cool that they were able to save a lot of these. Oh, and that tree. Yep, definitely remember hanging out under these trees before I got my car and was able to drive off campus. We would come out front here and eat lunch. But this is looking really nice, Gresham High School, I have to say. And this is, I believe, this is the new. Feels funny walking through here too. I don't think I've walked through this grass in probably 20 years. I didn't even come to my high school reunion. Oh, this, they were able to keep the gym as well. I just now noticed that. So they were able to keep the original parts of the gym too. Very cool. As you can see, it's kind of that old school with the football. The wrestling. Oh, I'm sorry, that's basketball. And then we got baseball too. Which I played basketball and baseball. Made varsity basketball, but kind of got sidetracked. But this is cool. This is very nice, I have to say. I really enjoy that they kept the original facade of the whole school. Well, not the whole school, but mainly parts of the cool front pieces. But that's it. That's Gresham High School. And I think that's pretty darn cool that, you know, I would have never thought I went to the same high school as her. And all these years later, to think that I actually still watch ALF. And knowing that the mom was so cool too, not to mention, you know, it's like she was so cool and I loved her outfit. She always wore like really funky, like 80s and 90s style clothing or hair. She was just kind of artsy. And I love both of the characters, the mom and the dad. I loved the whole show, but I really loved both the folks. And then ALF, of course, everybody loves ALF. But that's going to do it, you guys. And I'll also enter some more roles that she appeared in via TV and everything else like that over her career. But I just thought that was so cool, really. And you know, you grow up watching the shows and seeing the characters. I would have never thought she was right here in Gresham, Oregon. Her family actually lived on a little farm just kind of right outside Gresham, almost Portland. And they lived on a little farm, and she, you know, she decided, hey, instead of being an introvert and shy all the time, why don't I get into something that will, you know, keep me busy and really just pursue what she wanted to do. And when I listened to the quick little interview that she gave, I'm not sure, it may have been recently, I'm not sure exactly what year it is, but it's a little farther after the show because they were actually asking her questions about the show and stuff. I'll try and leave links to that because it's a really cool interview. But that's gonna do it for today. I love you guys very much for always tuning in. I want you guys to stay cool. It's gonna be definitely a hot one. Make sure you guys are staying hydrated, and you know, check on folks if you know anybody that may need a little assistance or maybe just some water. I love you guys very much, and tune in. Make sure you guys are tuning in, because we got a lot more good creeps coming. Again, I love the show ALF. He's probably one of my favorite aliens. I love Kang and Kodos from The Simpsons, because I'm a huge Simpsons fan anyways, but I love ALF. He's always made me laugh. I remember sitting there and watching him growing up early Saturday mornings. It's still on. I think MeTV plays them. Check your local listings. And I know that there are shows available online still. So that's going to do it from Gresham. I'm going to find me a cat to eat. That's right, ALF. Hide your cats. I'm coming. Peace, you guys.
That's going to do it from the planet Melmac. If you're new here, make sure you ring that bell. That way when I creep, you guys will be the first to creep. You can also hit that red subscribe button and become a creeper today. I love you guys. Till next time, Kreeper out for now.